Hey, my super beautiful, lovely, gorgeous souls. It's Lizzie the Lightworker here. Welcome, guys, to my channel. I'm doing a reading today for Scorpio, and this is going to be for messages while in separation from your twin. So what I'm going to do is pull some cards. I've got beautiful butterfly oracle cards,
Doreen Virtue,
and I've got these beautiful sacred traveler cards by Denise Lynn. And I'll pull other cards in as I feel needed. But for right now, what we'll do is we'll just ask, what are some general messages that Scorpio can benefit from Spirit, that will help in twin separation? Okay, let's get our first message out. So we're getting grief work. So Scorpio, I don't know if you've lost somebody recently or if you're just in grief over losing your twin, or the separation process has been grief.
What Spirit wants you to know is that you have to work through these emotions, and sort of if you're deciding to let something die or to hold on to it, that's what I'm feeling. There's a period of transition, or should be a period of transition, where you're starting to come out of that daily grief and wanting to either heal it or just accept the fact that you're gonna feel this way. Okay, so that's a message we're getting. And like I said, if it is an actual physical grief, like the loss of someone or the death of someone, angels want you to know that they are on your side. They're listening. They're trying to help you heal and want you to heal. Okay, this could have been also something that interrupted your union with your twin. Could it be that one of you had to leave for, you know, grieving or dealing with bereavement? Or it could be that, you know, you both are feeling this energy now of this grief without each other, but you have to work through it and you have to figure out where the cause of the grief is really lying and how did it lie between the two of you. So someone felt that there was a deep need inside for this grief to be worked out. Let's get another message. And support. So these are kind of going together in a way, because grief and support, I feel like maybe you were not as supported as you needed to be, or you're not feeling as supported as you need to be. It could also be that you were reliant upon it from your twin and you may not have got it from them. They may not been able to give it to you. So it could be that, you know, you're lacking that. It could be something that you need more of. Especially in separation. So if something drove your twin away from you and it did have to do with grief and you didn't get the support you needed, or you were the one that was going through the grief and it drove your twin away possibly and you didn't get the support that you needed, either way, I do feel like Spirit wants you to know that you may have to seek it. You may have to look for groups that you can join, or possibly maybe some therapy even, to work out what's blocked, what's not being released, what's not being relieved, okay? Let's get another message out here. And we're getting windfall. So things may be sort of taking a turn for the better now. As far as your mood and the way that you're feeling, there should be something that sort of either pulls you out or has pulled you out of the funk. And, you know, kind of learning that maybe it's not so bad. I feel like, you know, you might be more accepting of this now, this separation. Like you may have come to a point where you're like, you know, this is not so bad and I really do need to learn what I need to learn, or I have to heal some more, or I have some more grief to do. You know, sometimes it could be we're grieving ourselves. Some people live in chronic pain and they miss their former self. That's a good example. The person that they used to be before the pain every day. So that could apply too for emotional pain. So I feel like turn for the better is definitely coming in terms of emotions and sort of settling and sort of acceptance, okay? So let's get another card. Oh, sorry. And we're getting Be True to You. Sorry for the bump. So Be True to You. So this is a good message because it's almost like we could lose ourselves in separation. We're really supposed to be finding ourselves, but I feel like we lose ourselves first. Then we have to find ourselves again. I feel like our twin shows us who we really are, you know, that mirror
mirroring that we do with our twin. It's just unbelievable. They are really showing us who we are and what we're afraid of and what we need to do and deal with and heal. So being true to you is recognizing these things and being willing and open to serve yourself. Definitely. Okay, so let's get another message. And we're also getting heavenly signs. So again, I don't know if you lost somebody, Scorpio, and that, you know, you're receiving messages from heaven. That's very possible. It could also be your guides. You may be having like dreams like of passed on loved ones, or maybe someone that you lost recently is trying to communicate with you to let you know that they're okay. Grief is a big theme here, okay? So I don't know if this happened to sort of provoke a separation, like I said, or if it's happening sort of now, or it's maybe a couple of months ago that led into this. But yeah, pay attention to signs, Scorpio. You may get some answers if you're asking. You know, if you're asking the angels to show you the way or show you a better way to heal, and they give you something like a song or a book is put in your view, or, you know, a license plate, something. It's things like that. Very subtle, the way that spirit communicates, but they will make it so it will be on your path. Yeah, so heavenly signs we're getting. So let's get one more, and then I would like to get some sacred traveler cards out. So we're getting healing from the past. So a lot of healing here in this reading. A lot of, I feel like, grief work healing. We're getting changes, sort of betterment. We're getting like that card windfall. That's sort of like, you know, the bad times are almost over. Okay, so I feel like something may be thrusting you into the healing part. I feel like you know that you need to do this in order to better align yourself with your twin, okay? And I get a little sense that you may have not been willing to accept what was wrong, like right away. This is something that took time for you to come to a realization about. Something that I feel like your twin came and cracked your world open and let you really see where you were making mistakes and where there were faults and where there were things that needed to be healed or fixed, okay? And I do feel like the past part of this, it could be the past with your twin, or it could be the past prior to your twin, pre-twin, okay? Think about those things. Think about maybe where there's something that needs healing from the past. Is it partially maybe like a forgiveness piece? Okay, that's very possible. It could be that, you know, you need to be fully accepting of a forgiveness piece, okay? Or for forgiving yourself, possibly. It could be inner child work as well. It could be something from the past that needs healing. It could also be a relationship that you had prior to your twin that needed, you know, sort of, I think, closure. I'm looking for, that's the word I'm looking for, closure, okay? So I feel like spirit wants you to know in separation that, you know, yes, you need to do some healing. Yes, I feel like, you know, you need to do some accepting. Yes, I feel like you need to sort of, you know, go and look in your past and kind of try to pinpoint, you know, maybe what is some shadow work or some shadow part of yourself that, you know, your twin maybe identified to you and you've had some time to think about it now. What is that part of you that needs healing? Okay, that's what spirit wants you to know. And let's get some sacred traveler cards here. So we're getting unknown territory. And the message is you are exactly where you need to be, okay? So don't panic about the process or the timing. You know, you could have watched something from a year ago and you're maybe not just there just yet. It's all a process, guys. It's time. It's like, you know, no amount of time may be enough for one person that it is enough for someone else. No amount of distance. It's just that greater happiness that we have to go after. So I feel like spirit is teaching you lessons. You're learning lessons on this spiritual journey in separation from twin. They're telling you, don't be fearful to keep going. Don't be fearful, you know, of the unknown, because it's all for a purpose. It's all to help you grow and learn and heal and to put you back to finding your beautiful twin. So let's get another card, and we're getting Ascending the Mountain. So keep going forward. Whatever you're doing is working, okay? All the healing and all the grief work type stuff, that takes time. So don't beat yourself up if it's not quite where you want to be, or maybe you're just starting this process, okay? So don't beat yourself up. Keep going through the motions, keep doing, keep functioning, keep living, okay? You will get to where you need to be, okay? And we're going to get one more, and we're getting view from above. Get the big picture, okay? So make sure you see the big picture here in separation. Make sure you're learning what you need to learn. Let this information sort of absorb and sink in. When you have these realizations, they're correct, okay? Spirit communicates with you that way to put stuff in your head, pop things into your head that are correct for you to do or try, or an energy to be in, or something to purge, or all those things are important, okay? And it's also about sort of making promises to yourself to sort of fulfill your goals and your destinies and, you know, your self-repair and your healing, okay? I hope you guys enjoyed this. Let me know what you think. Give me a big thumbs up. Don't forget to like and share. Check the description box, because I did start a twin flame separation group on Facebook, and I find it, people are really loving it. Everybody's connecting and talking about their experiences. It's just really wonderful. And I like to do pick a card and little mini readings in the group. So check it out. And I'll see you guys on the next reading. Love and light. Thank you so much for watching.